Mankind discovers pets.
Oh, very funny, Bob.
Alrighty then. Here we go. Yet more infinite story. Let me just check something quickly. Because I think I was given, like, maybe one or two hints on something else. Right, no, that's fine. So, where am I going here? I think it's the blacksmith I want. So, what's in my pile of crap? A few things. Right. What I'm looking for, I don't think I have steel though. I think steel is the one thing I'm missing. Where did I dump it? Here. Yeah, so... what do I need to make Damascus? It is steel 2 plus Moloch 2. To make steel 2, it is iron plus wood material. Which I'm going to find out. I have no iron. Yep. Unless I can buy some. Which I'm guessing is what I'm looking at here. Is there anything in the inn? Don't have anything. That's wood. That count as wood? Two or cedar. Yeah, it should count as wood. And then... what's the other thing I'm sort of looking at here? I think I also need, what do you count as a dagger? Yes. Steel axe. I could try and unlock stuff from that, but I don't think so. Cotton. Okay, I think I'm missing stuff for this. This FAQ to do anything with that. Don't have iron. Don't think I've got quartz, nor do I have silver. I have neither. Okay. I have a silver sword. That's not what I'm looking for. Alright, I'm gonna need to head out on some adventures then. Do the night mausoleum. So what I'm looking for, and it's a very simple one, is I need Damascus plus Moloch 2. To make anything out of that. Oh crap. Well, this is always good. I don't even know what I don't have the fifth character yet. I don't even know what I'm looking for in this place. That's next dialogue. So the person I need to use is Michelle. She has time lapse. Time lapse is the ability that I need to use. Speedy Bleedy. Okay, he does have it. Alright. Inspiration. Backslash. Already 2 life points done without actually killing it, without actually attacking it. Oh, fuck off, Aquans. Right, so Speedy Bleedy is the other one, is the other inspiration move that I need. Speedy Bleedy, if you do it correctly enough and set it up nicely, becomes Bloody Mary, which is one of the best dagger moves in the entire game. Healed? No, Michelle is still not healed. Michelle, please. Please, Michelle!
Wow, that's so cool!
There's no one to pull the point against. That's the problem. Oh, fuck. Yeah. I think it was 2 life points already. Two life points. Yep, just going straight for that kill shot now. Bird is surprisingly resilient. Why is this bird so resilient? It should be dead by now. I think I may have to reset anyway, because I might need to outfit them with better armor. Thank you. I don't even know what I'm doing in this place yet. Does this have the Squaresoft reset? It does not. Interesting. Oh, fucking thing's broken again. And straight through, straight to the life points. But the only thing I would lose is backslash level 2, that's it. Oh, more Aquans. I am not surprised.
Hi there. How you doing?
Michelle's probably going to die. Yep. She's already down to 3 life points. Yeah, I think this is automatically a KO. Fucking Christ, this place. This area. This entire game. Reverse Delta. There it is. That's the move. 3 life points immediately. No, I still have not understood what combos are. Because. That's how fucking archaic this game is. It does not tell you squat. Like, all the combos that I've had have basically been negative against me. And considering I haven't read anything on it yet, is exactly why. I don't know anything. I want to do at least one of these without doing that. Oh, hold, then go. Okay. Oh my god, what a fucking mess. Time-lapse reverse delta. Not that it matters, I'm gonna die here anyway. Because I keep running into shit like this. Laura's still poisoned. Yeah, Michelle's gonna be dead in a minute. Which then raises the question, why would I use combos? They seem like an absolute detriment half the time. Wait, this is meant to be going down to the bottom of the stairs, isn't it? Low skill like spell first. Okay. Oh, right. Right, so I'd have to use Judy most of the time to start with. And she can't... Oh, she can use Rainbringer? What's that? Oh, I think Michelle's dead. Fuck! Well, that's a big if the wheel starts spinning. Every time I go to hold, it just keeps breaking the combo, so at the moment it seems like, as I said, a detriment. Yeah, that insect should be dead. The only problem is I have to die before I'm allowed to go back and do other things. We know what the setup for reverse delta is, which is like the big things that I need to do for this. I'm almost out of life points. Oh, there's a locked door here, but I can't get in. Probably quite a few. Yeah, 90. Alright, fuck it, reset the console. 90 turns. No. I'm not waiting that long. What did I do? Nothing. I didn't really do much before I did the next adventure. I'm guessing Avalon is actually the story progression, as I thought last time. The problem is that the axe level 3, it's not, okay. All these are optional. The thing is, what I'm looking at here, is that I need to get the axe on everybody else. Oh, I think I found it.
Your Highness.
Oh, I'm guessing this is my fifth character. Not.
Pablo, tell me, what should I do now?
Party 5, okay.
I was relieved to see the expression on her face. Lore would most likely be angry and tell me not to be impudent. But I was worried about leaving Lore all alone.
The Return. Okay, so that's the main one. Francis. Right, so he should... If I'm looking at how Unlimited Saga attacks correctly, Francis would probably be the tank of the group. I'd mostly have to get him to go first. Give you like a shield to hold? Yes, but that makes you even worse. The thing is, because I've like solved part of my problem, I'm not entirely too certain what to do now. Have nothing on them anyway. Have some boots. Sword, I think it's silver sword I have here. Now the better question I have to think about here is, do I do some of the optional stuff to see if I can get more axe wielders, or do I do I just continue on the story? Because I'm kind of uncertain on this one. No, I've made a save before this anyway, so if everything does go tits up, fuck it. We've already got quite a large number of monsters. Alright. Like, ideally, I would like Francis to have the axe, so he's able to use time-lapse.
Your Highness, please, allow me.
He has a stone spear, and he has a silver sword. Right, now I need to focus on Ari and Michelle. Fuck's sake, Michelle, come on. No, I'm gonna have to stop you on that one. The best weapons are arrow, knife, and gun. They're not gun, sorry. Arrow, knife, and axe because of their reliability. Do not believe what you've seen on that one. I'm already very, very much well aware what the, actually, hold on a second. Hold on a second here. Something just clicked. If I use combos, I'm losing out on inspiration by the looks of things. I should have a level 2 axe skill right now, considering the level of the enemy. But I don't think combos help it in the slightest. Hit barrier ability. God, this fucking game is a mess. I've already lost a bunch of... Already lost a bunch of LP anyway. Mostly because of how that first battle went. I think he has a level 3. Because most of my, like, saga knowledge is based entirely upon Legend of Legacy, in which you couldn't combo anything. Not a single skill. You had to kind of think a couple of turns ahead. Alliance Alive is much like that as well. Skills does... Oh, not bad here, Av. Sword arts, spear arts, bow arts. He has a bow art, so I should probably get him to go, to have a bow. I have no idea about ephemeral ephemeral fantasy, because it's not one that I've played. You'd have to ask Dane about that one. And mimic. That's an absolute hard on for the king here. And now it's killing Michelle. It's either that or the spark is more likely to happen with just a normal standard attack. It's already been diffused. Come on, gang. Locksmith. No, that's the wrong one. I have level 3. And it's going to explode in my face anyway. Oh, good. Yeah, this unlock might not happen. Oh, there we go. Oh, money, okay. So Laura's able to heal surprisingly fast. It's a Kefka, she's able. Wildlings and insects.
You'll never know an enemy's true power until you face it.
Yeah, I think, like, Thursday is probably one of the quietest days on Twitch, anyway. Fuck's sake! I need Reverse Delta to stop being a bitch. Hmm. The problem is, there is an item that I could use. Oh, for... Wait, she's dead! Are you trying to trap kill someone who is already deceased? Okay, I'm not fucking with those giant beasts. Much as I'd like to get more iron and stuff, I need to buy those, I guess. Slimes aren't particularly harmful. I'll leave them alone. There's more of them. That's definitely more like it. Diffuse. I need a higher diffuse level. Or for this thing to not be trapped half the time. With magic. Fuck, I forget how to unlock it with magic. Oh, Earth Familiar? Shit, I can't remember how to unlock it with magic. Oh, hold on, Oh, what's her name? Can't do that yet. And it exploded. Doesn't matter. Some speedy bleedy. Ah, it is now unlocked for 10k. Well, it's better than nothing. Oh, right. Let me just do some equipment sorting here. Equip. Else's stuff looking particularly damaged. Not for the minute. Play some stone spear. Darn it. Game, can you, you know, stop being an asshole for 5 seconds? Never mind. I forget. Old Royal Ascot boy here has got diffuse level 3. You should have a better success chance. And still failed. All I've received for this one has been money. Okay. Judy, rescue. Throw. Rear blade. Speedy bleedy. So it takes two turns to rescue someone? That seems a little odd. No, I don't think it can be used, so throw Michelle out of here. Fuck off. Yeah, I can't rescue, Judy. Not Judy. Michelle. No point in trying to rescue anyone. Yeah, everything's just breezing through my defenses. And I don't have all my turns anymore. Yeah, I start on turn 3. Double missed. Right, he's finally up. Oh, I gotta remember. I only have 3 turns, not 5. Because Laura's fucking dead. Not Laura, fucking... Because Michelle's dead, as usual. And I'm not doing any life point damage. Have I just entered into, like, an unwinnable fight because it's not doing anything? Yet the slimes are not taking life point damage. This is concerning. Frost. The Sonic Thrust is technically still under the same thing, so I'm not entirely certain about that one. Finally, something.
I am all right. I can go on.
That wasn't enough. The slime is invincible. There. Killed it. Multi-hit. Null Darkness. I'm knocking a lot of the stuff on the, She's dead. She's dead. It doesn't matter. Michelle is dead. Speedy bleeding. It was stunned. Cut in. Well, that's level 3, so obviously I need the level 4 one for that to be complete. Don't focus on the reel again. You know what happened last time you did. Just disarm the damn trap. We'll blow up either way. It's only a level 40 chest. How is it providing you with so much challenge? And all I'm getting is money. I now have a gnat flying past my stuff.
Why in the world am I even bothering with Henri? Can't be because I'm lonely, can it?
Still on the high road. And we have wildlands. What the hell? Many channel points are on this one. 240,000.
Okay.
Gotta remember. Double mist. No stun. Twin blade. Cut in sight thrust. All that damage. Only one life point lost. Bleedy and hammer for. Still only one! Nonri's about to die, so I need to do something. Oh, that's not a good attack to see, because I think normally that would be instant death. Just retreat for 5 seconds because it's I need health, quite a lot of it. Wait, what's happening to my chat box? It's acting weird. There we go. I was like, why is this display showing a message before I've seen it? I think it's currently... Both these two have no health and no way of regaining it very fast. I'm out of here. Birds scare me. Oh, this insect is already going to kill me anyway. It's on its own, though. That's gonna matter, because it'll do two shuriken throws anyway. I may as well not even attempt a combo, because that's the first thing it does. If I can throw and stun it, it should mean I can do more, or I can kill it with a throw.
Didn't even put up a fight.
Turns out the chickens want to have an egg song. No, it's an egg sombler. That was a shitty joke. And it explodes on me. Lurkers. Lurkers are afraid. I still don't know why I typed that message. Cutting, as it turns out, very good for life point damage on certain things. Yay, hurt a dead person. The body is... like, Michelle's body has got to be mutilated beyond all repair at this point. Birds are staying away from me, unless there's wildlings involved. Everyone combos! Combo, combo, combo! Why do you have so many life points? I'm not anywhere close to the boss yet. I think I'm dead. I'm just wondering if it's because my equipment's bad. Well, that was a very quick stun. Already back to it. Take the pain! Another one? Didn't she lay an egg last time? Defuse level 4. There's Axe Arts level 3. That means I have another axe user. I mean, that's free magic if I have the wooden water familiar. What happens if I turn it to just punch? Okay. Sword arts level 4. Yeah, that'll help your strength quite a bit. Merchant rank upgrade. More commodities are available, better merchandise has arrived. You know what you need to tell those chickens to do? Eat pies. That's all I can think of.
Do not weep. You shall not let Laura see your tears ever again.
Right, last place to do any optionals. What am I looking? There's literally... Wait. You upgraded everything. And yet... I don't think they have an axe either. Titan Flute and Hanging Gardens. Hmm, use a little quick link. It's been a long day. This is a better question I'm going to ask here. Are there more shops after this? I'm now actually trying to think. Nothing on the world is closed off. Can we actually leave town? Because I kind of want to go get more axes. Oh, okay. It's being really fucking funny about that, aren't I? Chickens, I hear chickens. hi Titan. Like, that was being really odd with me earlier. Materials, snake skin, no. Cause what I'm looking at here is that even if I can't get time-lapse immediately on some axes, I can probably just... Okay, it won't let me do it if I'm too zoomed in on the map. Or I can get a bow, which would also be useful. There's the fang axe. I mean, we are, if I remember correctly now, we are in part 6 of this particular story. There's a stone axe. That'll be useful. Buckler? No. Fang sword? Fang amulet? Because you can manually learn stuff, like the next attack's down. And then it's just the inspiration and the spark stuff. Vaftum. Axe. Bone axe. There's another one. Take that one. Bone axe is useful. that knife. I also need to repair my items. Well, at least one of them. Cold, frozen north. This is where we started. Wait, what? This was the first town. How did I not see this? All right. Ow. Oh, this isn't open. Okay. Should I do the optional quest up here, or maybe do the ones in Vaftum instead? Avalon and Nightmare are really hard, okay. Did I have any other ones? Adventures, no new adventures. What's the other one in there then? In Vaftum? I haven't really increased my armor because I don't know why. The other one, Tribal Chief's Trial, is the last one. Oh, right. Battle rank is high enough. Okay. Damn it! I was hoping to get there before the Aquans attacked. Participant limit 3. Okay. Oh, right. I've already picked my 3. Let's try and get that reverse delta back. Better quick fix skill. Flash barrier multi-poke. that limit, yeah. I keep forgetting to fucking equip Judy with an axe. She has the capability. Judy, fuck the staff. Take the axe. Oh wait, shit, there was a way of going forward through there. Three life points, dead. Fucking hell. Ash ability. Oh, I didn't open the other treasure chest. Oh, fuck. We're back to this problem again. You have 19 life points. Stop losing them so fast. Lost 9 life points already in this quest. That's not a good sign. Like all backslash. Both of them got it now. Means that I am one away from reverse delta. And then I just need to keep up a decent supply of axes. Ah, Michelle is already dead. I'm not really feeling this game today. Like, my brain's just wanting to do something else. At the moment, I am bleeding life points all over the place for this side quest. Don't worry, the sack also has poison in it as well. I did defuse this, right? Oh, there's no traps out. A staff. Great. Who are these fuckers? Yes, this is the altar. Francis, please. Stop losing LP so fast. Michelle, you're fucking dead. So my battle rank is shit, according to this game. Oh, there are three of them. There's another one in the back I can't see. Yeah, I think I'm dead. Again. Yep, there he is. One right at the back. I'm gonna run out of life points before I can actually do anything. I'm doing none to these monsters. And they are just destroying me. Also, I would love the game to not recognize a single time lapse. It is multiple, thank you very much. It's a fucking level 2 one. Okay. I've killed two of them. And I have no life points left. Sebastian, Francis has 6, Michelle has 1, Judy has 2, Laura has 2. Most of these are dead. I still have 1 to purify. Yeah, I think Judy's dead.
Who has fallen?
Yeah, I don't think I'm doing this one. I think I'm dead. Actually, I don't think. I know I'm dead. I bet the next altar I find, I'm gonna get three more of them. And there's the exit. And I'm dead! Because I wandered in the wrong place. So according to the game, my battle rank is fantastic, apparently. I've made a mistake. Like, I think that's a level 3 wildling just sat in the center of there. Oh, you're not using an axe again. If I'm getting a skill almost immediately, I think that indicates that it's a very difficult quest and I'm going to get killed. just want to say this is a level 1 undead that's just decided it wanted to kill me. Don't start hurting Michelle's fucking LP, she hasn't got any. Oh, this is before I bought the... Oh no, that's the axe. Let's get to it. Start grinding out these abilities. Or, you know, Laura can just kill them with a single throw. I mean, to be fair, today we've already made, like, story progress, which is something. More than I did last week. Well, I have a feat. Oh, for pity. Crying out, fuck, man. A level 82 chest. I ain't getting in that one, am I? No. I'm thinking that the difficulty is a bit on the milder side for this one. Probably until I meet the boss, and then the boss kills me. Well, I imagine it's a case of going all the way up the stairs and then coming back down. Meeting constant undead. Oh boy. How many turns is this? 400, okay. Oh, come on. Why do they have treasure levels so damn high? Like, surely you should be on the first game, like, not having it that big? Just a hunch. Into this, like, sensibility of never want... Oh, absolutely meaningless. Good. Unspear. Got into this, like, good habit of constantly checking for traps on these treasure chests. Staff. Okay. Oh. The one thing I wish the game had was the ability to run away, and it doesn't. Yay, I obtained a feather. Well worth it. A secret door appears to have opened somewhere. Okay, which floor? Is it in here? Yes. Okay, there are two magic circles on the floor. I shouldn't trust either of them, should I? Let's pick one and live while we're young. That removes one turn from this whole debacle. Knew it. Right, one down. But that's the reason I'm using throw so much, is because throw has the possibility of stunning, which removes a turn from them. Inspiration, backslash. Load it up. Fuck it. Excuse me. The Laura is starting to lose LP, which is something I don't want to see. Wait, this was a magic circle room. How do I... Okay. Send me back. Good. But this piece of music wouldn't be out of place in a game called Symphony. The Symphony is actually a very good ride-along music shoot 'em up. It's one I can't really play for good reason, because, you know, copyright and shit. Can you hit someone other than Judy, please? Is that possible? The moment I'm bringing in Michelle, she's going to get fucking whacked for a good amount of her life points. Another cops. That's actually reasonably useful. This floor seems to have been mostly those encounters. I really hope there's a way of getting back down to the first floor without any issues. And down goes Michelle again. Oh, mostly. Of magic circles, probably all interconnected. Oh. This is a case of guess the right one. Just leave one of them. So not really guess the right one at all, is it? I'm not going to even risk doing a combo. I imagine it's got the next move as well. Oh no, it doesn't. Okay. One move? Doesn't seem right to me.
Have we won already?
Life protection. I'm hoping that's the skill it actually is. It, like, is capable of defending my life points rather than being just useless. That's a big old demon.
You'll never know an enemy's true power until you face it.
Also, it looks like with the combo system, all the moves are completely random, so... Yeah. All that just for one life point damage. I think it's still got an attack up its sleeve. So I'm not gonna just go all in. Or it is. There's reverse delta. Good, duty is complete. No. I'd like to be able to finish this one, because I think I'm starting to run out of turns. Especially considering how, like, painfully slow the movement is. No. Level 78. No. No way. is still ascending. Well, right, okay, no, never mind. Level 70 chests, I'm just like, it's not worth it. It's not worth it in the slightest. There might be some good loot in there, but I don't think so somehow. Who just came online? Alright, I'm looking for the fucking red ones now, aren't I?
That's so touching. That was easy, but I've got to stay sharp.
Oh god, although this adventure is taking quite a long time. This is actual hardware, I can't just... Oh no, I can stop, can't I? There's a quick save option. Ah, a guardian beast. I'm going to use the loot before it starts killing me. Right, Guardian Beast, so, set up. Ideally I want to get Michelle to go last, so that she can hit reverse delta. Oh no, she doesn't have reverse delta yet, but... if I can remove its turns in a specific way... see if that works. I'm not going to combo until I know what sort of turns it makes. Yeah, I need to make sure that I'm using using reverse delta with Judy. Well, it must be impressive watching Laura just try and, you know, throw this asshole to death. And there it goes. Magic Saber. The magic seal is broken. Yeah, I know. I want to heal first game, shut up. Oh, there's 5 magic seals. Okay. Each one of them with a guardian beast behind, I imagine. That's Leviathan. Three of 5 need to be killed. Oh god, I don't know which one's which. This might have been the wrong choice. Oh, inspiration, roundabout. What? That hits everyone. Yeah, this was a mistake. Now, Laura is starting to bleed life points, which means if I try and fight one more, I'm gonna game over from critical character death. Yep. I chose the wrong one to attack. No, I think this has been half an hour of time wasted, because I am running out of life points. And it also means I lose reverse Delta again. That's the first. Oh my fucking lord. That's the first point of life damage I've done. Because the thing is, if Laura or Henri goes down, that's it. The game just goes, nah, you died. I have to stress that part. It has lead protagonist syndrome. Are you fucking serious? Still haven't done a single point of life damage. No, I've done 1 point of life damage, that's it. And it's already starting to combo inside my own combos. Two points of life damage. And no one has, apart from Francis, no one has any life points left. So that's it, I'm fucked. Judy's down. And Laura is not finished yet.
Laura!
There we go, that's game over. Yeah, that's it. Lead protagonist syndrome is not a fucking good design choice. Why do games insist on putting it in? On that note, let's get to raiding. But this is what fucking kills me about most, not just retro gaming, it's modern gaming as well. No one, I repeat, fucking no one does lead protagonist syndrome well. And it's the thing that pisses me off to the nth extent. Oh, it's so daring in Persona 5. No, it's shit. Fuck off. There's only been one game I can think of which introduced the mechanic and made it work, which was Valkyrie Profile. Other than that, it's been trash. Actually, no, I tell a lie, Amori did it well as well. Other than that, that is two examples out of a laundry list of games that have done it. No, stop putting it in. You can't make it work. Alright, who have I got? But this is one of my biggest rants about gaming in general, is that system. If you can't make it work, don't put it in. Like, let me explain what I mean by this. Valkyrie profile, if Lenith went down, you get 3 turns every single time she went to 0 HP to recover her. Otherwise, she would be killed, and the game would be over. Amori allows him to have at least, if he is over 1 HP, the ability to last stand. That's the 2 good examples I can give with it. Every other one, no. Just fucking no. And Persona has this problem, and it's something I can't stand about it. If the protagonist reaches 0 HP in any other game that I have found that comes across with this system, that's it. It's game over. You don't get a choice in the matter. But I will stream, like, happily after this, I will stream Valkyrie Profile. I fucking will. Just to back up what I'm saying. Because Valkyrie Profile 2 doesn't have this system because they got rid of it. They knew it was a bad idea. Okay then, we're going to go see our good old buddy Dark Swash. And tomorrow I'm going to try and figure out this fucking mess. Hopefully get somewhere.